Hi friends, so far we have seen the treatment of outstanding expenses, prepaid expenses, closing stock and depreciation in the final accounts. Today I shall explain two other items. They are number one, accrued income, number two, unearned income or income received in advance. What do you mean by accrued income? The income which is earned but not received, that is accrued income. Any income which relates to the current accounting period but that remains unrealized is called accrued income. This accrued income may appear either in the adjustment or in the trial balance. Then how it is to be considered in the final accounts? I shall illustrate it with an example. Here, two trial balances are given. In the first case, rent as an income in the credit column of the trial balance is given as rupees 10,000. Then in the adjustment, rent accrued rupees 2,000 is given. Let us see how it will appear in the P&L account and balance sheet. Rent received is an indirect income showing a credit balance. That item should be taken on the credit side of the P&L account by rent. Being an income, it can be credited. How you arrive at the decision that it is an income? Because it appears in the credit column of the trial balance. This rupees 10,000 is without making any adjustment of rupees 2,000 with respect to rent accrued. The total rent of the concern is the rent which appeared in the trial balance and the rent accrued which is given in the adjustment. The total of these two items should be taken in the P&L account. Rent rupees 10,000 and rent accrued rupees 2,000. Total 12,000 must be credited in the profit and loss account. Then this being an adjustment item, it will again be taken at another place. This is an amount which is due from others. Any amount due from others is an asset for us. Therefore, it should be shown as an asset in the balance sheet. In the balance sheet, rent accrued rupees 2,000. Then what about the second case? Here a trial balance is given on 31st March 2020, wherein two items are given. That is, rent with a credit balance of rupees 10,000 and rent accrued a debit balance of rupees 2,000. Whenever rent accrued in the trial balance, it implies that that amount is already added to the rent received. So, this rupees 10,000 is inclusive of this rent accrued rupees 2,000. Therefore, there is no need for further addition of this rupees 2,000 to the rent in the P&L account. Instead, the rent which is given in the trial balance as it is can be taken in the P&L account as an income. That is, P&L account, by rent, rupees 10,000. Then rent received appeared in the trial balance. It should be taken only at one place in the final accounts. That is the amount due from others. So it is an asset. It will appear on the asset side of the balance sheet. That means in the balance sheet, we can write rent accrued rupees 2000. Then the second item, that is unearned income or income received in advance. Unearned income simply means the income already received, but it is not earned. That portion of income which belongs to the next accounting period, which is already received during the current year, is called this unearned income or received in advance income. We are not eligible to get now, but actually it is realized in this year itself. That is unearned income. How it is to be dealt with in final accounts? That depends upon whether it is given in the adjustment or in the trial balance. I shall illustrate it with an example. There are two trial balances are given. In the first case, there is one item in the trial balance with a credit balance, that is rent. Whenever rent is given as a credit balance, it implies that this is an income. Then, in the adjustment, it is given that there is unearned rent of rupees 5000. It means of the rent which is given in the trial balance as rupees 20,000, 5,000 belongs to the next accounting period. Therefore, in the profit and loss account, we should take only the rent which relates to the current accounting period. That is, from the total of rupees 20,000, we have to subtract 5,000 that relates to the next accounting period. Thereby, we will get what is the rent for the current accounting period. It can be taken in the P&L account. That is, in the P&L account, by rent rupees 20,000 less unearned rent rupees 5,000, remaining 15,000 in the amount column of the P&L account. Then, this being an income received in advance, that is a liability, no doubt. Whenever any amount is received from a party in advance, it will be a liability for us. Therefore, it must be shown on the liability side of the balance sheet. That is balance sheet, unearned rent rupees 5000. Then take the second case. Here the two items are given in the trial balance. First one, rent with a credit balance of rupees 15,000, and the second one, unearned rent with a credit balance of rupees 5000. Whenever unearned rent appears in the trial balance, it conveys that this amount is already deducted from the rent received. Therefore, no need for further subtraction. Hence, the rent which is given in the trial balance can be directly credited in the P&L account, and the unearned rent given in the trial balance can be directly shown as a liability in the balance sheet. Hence, in the P&L account, we can write by rent 15,000, then in the balance sheet, rent received in advance rupees 5,000. I shall summarize the treatment of the two items discussed today in a table, namely the accrued income and unearned income. First one, accrued income. Whenever accrued income is given in the adjustment, It should be added to the concerned income in the profit and loss account and should also be shown as an asset in the balance sheet. But whenever it is given in trial balance, it should be shown as an asset in the balance sheet. The second one, income received in advance, otherwise called unearned income. Whenever it is given in the adjustment, it should be deducted from the concerned income in the profit and loss account. And also, it should be shown as a liability in the balance sheet. Instead, if that item is given in the trial balance, you need to show it only at one place. That is, it should be shown as a liability in the balance sheet.